Hi, fellow dog fanciers. I hope you're doing amazing. It's almost weekend, so that must be a good feeling. This is the second time I'm trying to film this because the first time things just didn't work out. I tried to get the main characters that I'm going to talk about within the frame, but quickly after they decided that there is something very important to do outside, so I had to let them out. And also I was really unhappy with the result from the video, and I decided to refilm because I want to get the video out in time. And now I'm in my lunch break actually filming this video, and I'm quite lucky that I have very long lunch breaks for emergencies like that. So because from last week we were on the puppy topic, this week I wanted to tell you a little story. For those of you who have watched my other videos, you probably know that Jamie, Ruby and Ivy are sisters, but I wanted to tell you why we decided to keep the whole litter. So how we made this decision and why is it one of the craziest that I've ever made in my whole life? Keep watching to find out. So while it was still a plan, this litter was going to be very special. First of all, it was going to be Bailey's second and last litter. And second, I planned it for so long and I tried to execute that plan very carefully, because I have mentioned that these three are what I like to call frozen puppies, and everything around making such litter come true is very delicate, very pricey, and you just keep your fingers crossed and you hope that everything is going to work out as you planned. So they were very special since day one, and from the start, obviously, you could tell that they were very, very different from each other. And anyway, originally we had the plan that we're going to keep one and the other two were going to find wonderful homes abroad. And why all my puppies find homes abroad, except for those that stay with me, and why I don't keep any within the country is a topic for another video. So you know, every good breeder should love their puppies, but they should also be accepting of the fact that when the puppies turn a specific age, they will go to their own loving homes, and there is absolutely nothing wrong with that. And 3 litters long, I have done that successfully, and of course I have cried when every single puppy was leaving our home, but I found peace with the thought that they're going to be loved almost as much as I would love them if they stay at home. But with this litter, things were a little bit different. As they were growing and as they were developing, apart from color, which if you're a good breeder you shouldn't look at when it comes to whippets, because color in whippets is immaterial. So yeah, they were very different, but all of them were also very promising. So by week 5, I realized that I am starting to get a little too attached in the idea that maybe I will have a very hard time letting them go started creeping in my head. But I thought they're too little, and every time we have puppies and they're just so young, like just a few weeks old, I have this thing within me, this motherly instinct that I can't let them go because I feel like someone wants to steal my puppies from me or something. I don't know, it's very hard to explain. Unfortunately though, when they turned 7 weeks of age, the thought of them leaving our home became so unbearable for me. I really started making plans in my head, thinking that I am willing to sacrifice so much just for the sake of all of them staying at home. At the time, for different reasons that are irrelevant to this video, I had plans to move out. So I started looking into how can I make this possible sooner so that I could probably take one or two with me, because let's admit it, we had 5 whippets at a time and the idea of 8 dogs was a little bit too much. And keep in mind that at the time we've had 6 whippets at the same time at most. And the other thing was, because when it comes to animals, my mom is my real partner in crime. If it depended on us only, we were going to keep them all. But of course, my dad had his very reasonable points against that. In the meantime, I have some wonderful people messaging me about the puppies, and that was very special because many of them were really well-known names. They know the breed and it meant so much to me that they appreciated the puppy so much and that they really wanted to own one of my puppies, which I'm a young breeder, but it is so valuable to the effort that I put in, to all the sleepless nights which I use to make plans, to look at pedigrees, to learn more about the breed, because it might seem obvious that I know the breed being in it for so long, but believe me, if you want to, you will learn something new every single day. So when they turned 8 weeks of age, I posted the traditional stacked pictures, which was on Thursdays every week, I believe. And the number of messages I started receiving from people who were interested in the puppies was really overwhelming, and I'm not even over exaggerating. And you know the sound that Messenger makes on your phone? Yeah, every time I heard that, it felt like I had something stuck in my throat and I was almost about to start ugly crying. And at that day, I cried so much because, first of all, I had these 3 puppies that I was so attached to. Second, they were all so beautiful and so different that it was almost impossible for me to make a choice, even though I tried so hard. A bit like this hopeless feeling when you know that you really want to do something so much, but you know it is not possible, and the only thing left is sitting there feeling hopeless, and yeah, I don't know how else to describe it. It was a very dramatic period actually for me. So the next day, me and my family felt the need to sit down and discuss the whole situation. And to my surprise, my dad, being the fantastic, caring person that he is, simply said, "Let them all stay." And that took a little while for my brain to process, because something that you've known it's impossible for weeks and weeks, all of a sudden becomes so easy to do in a second. So now on how life has been so far with 3 puppies. I have explained in a previous video that owning a whippet puppy is a challenging task. Owning 3 is the trouble multiplied by 3. And owning 3 female whippet puppies is even worse. So for the first few months, they were real troublemakers, running around constantly, making arguments with each other, and being very annoying to the adult part of the pack. Luckily, they have not done too much of a damage. Something destroyed here and there, something stolen and later on found out destroyed, laying around somewhere in the garden, some holes being dug up in the garden, but nothing too serious. So because they're girls and they're willing to rule the world, they get into arguments fairly often, and we often witness something which I would like to call dominant sparring. They're competing for toys, for places to sleep, for human attention. I've mentioned before that things like this and the naughtiness, they go on until a whippet puppy turns around 18 months of age. But despite the challenges, I'm so grateful that we kept them, because they're so, so very special to us. They're so outgoing and it's such a joy to do things with them, regardless of what activity I'm trying to get them involved with, whether it's going to be shows or exercising or just even playing. I really feel like I have committed partners by my side, which is very, very dear to me. And another important reason why we feel so grateful is because we lost their mom, Bailey, at the beginning of the year. And I have briefly mentioned before that her passing was so unexpected, so sudden. The reason behind it is still a mystery. And all three girls carry a little bit of Bailey in them. And you know, I like to believe that in life everything happens for a reason, and almost every single day I find new reasons to be grateful for keeping a whole litter of puppies. And yet this will remain one of the craziest decisions that I have ever made with external support, of course, to this day. So this was the story for today. So thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you haven't done so yet. And have a wonderful weekend, of course. And I will see you next Friday with another video. Bye-bye.